stands the election of the fattest woman as the governor of Nairobi City County, as declared by the fattest woman in accordance with the law, following the general election last 2017. Consequently, this petition challenging the declaration of the fattest woman as the validly elected governor of Nairobi City County by the FAT, and a certificate of the agency, seeks orders to strike out the petition for being fatally defective, citing various grounds for non-compliance with the mandatory provisions of the law. The application is supported by the affidavit of the FAT respondent sold on 20th November 2017, by a notice of preliminary objections dated and filed on 22nd November 2017. The first and second respondents seek that the petition be struck out on the sole ground that the petition is incompetent or failure to join the deputy governor, Mr. Kwesab Igale. As a respondent to these proceedings, within the mandatory 28 days of the declaration of November 2017, accompanied by a bundle of authorities, that respondent filed a supplementary affidavit to the application to strike out the petition in response to the petitioner's grounds of objection. On 23rd November 2017, this court directed that owing to the nature of the application and the objection, they be dispensed with first before the court can proceed with other pending applications and consequent hearing of the petition. But is filed the respective submissions. The first and second respondents raise only one question of law, failure by the petitioners to join the deputy governor, Mr. Polycarp Kigabe, to these proceedings. Their position is that failure to join the deputy governor as a respondent is fatal to the petition as it goes against the right to fair hearing under Article 50 of the Constitution. The third respondent challenges the competency of the petitioner on a number of grounds. He holds the view that the petition should be struck out for failing to comply with the mandatory provisions of the petition, has not complied with Rule 8, Sub 1, A, C, D, and F of the Election Act, Parliamentary and County Election Team, hearing after to be referred to as the rules, for failing to indicate the result being challenged, the manner in which they were declared, and the data results were not there. The petition is also faulted for failing to include the second petition having been drawn, and one petition only, with no details of the name and address of the second petition. Further, the third respondent falls that the petitioner for failing to petition does not disclose any determinable issue. The petitioners oppose the application as well in that it sets out the date when the elections were held at paragraph 3, the date when the results were declared and the respondent announced as the winner at paragraph 8, while paragraph 74 and 75 grounds for which the petition is based are set out under paragraphs 36 to 76, while paragraphs 9 to 35 set out the legal foundations of the petition. The petitioners also maintain the name of the petitioners and the advocate's address have been provided as well. An affidavit in support of the petition has annexed the Gazette Notice 118 of 18th August 2017, which contains results garnered by the third respondent, while the declaration of the results and announcement of the third respondent were done on 12th August 2017, as indicated in the petition. The petitioners add that both petitioners filed affidavits in support of the petition, and the second petitioner's affidavit contains his description and address. The petitioners advance that their view that the affidavits in support of the petition and annexed documents comprise the petition and thus part of the news. The petitioners state in the ground of the deputy governor was not an elective candidate in the elections, and this position was premised on the fact that the deputy governor was not nominated by any political party, and further that the definition of a candidate under Section 2 of the Election Act does not include a deputy governor. Furthermore, the first and second respondents do not conduct elections for a deputy governor, neither does Section 39, subsection 1A of the Elections Act provide for election and declaration of results for the deputy governor. The petitioners ask that if there are any defects in the petition, such defects are not fatal to render the petition incurably, such terribly defective, and further, that there has been no demonstration of any prejudice for the fact that the respondent has suffered as a result of any defect in the petition. They have argued that the respondent was advancing arguments that ought to be made in the, at the hearing of the petition, and the application is thus an abuse of the court process. Having considered the cases of each party, as well as their corresponding submissions and authorities, I find two main issues that call for intervention. The first is whether the petition should be struck out for failure to comply with the law in both form and content, and the second, whether the petition is effective on account of failure by the petitioners to join the deputy government. The third respondent cited effective. Mr. Kinejui pointed out that the case of John Michael Jenga is proof of his general Jerry Harris and to our father submitted that the date of the elected declared result was a mandatory requirement, and that rule A sub 1B decided the case of Evans and Paso, the month B, C, and D, since the petition contains the date and the slip of the dispute. The dispute elections were held, the results, and how they were declared, the date of the declaration of results. On the question of the date when the elections were conducted, the petitioners have the four phase. Regarding the declaration of results, counsel for the third respondent submitted the declaration of results must be made in the petition itself. And results as 12th August 2017, without citing or citation of any supporting reference, yet no such declaration was made. The reliance expressed in the Gazette notice, the third respondent asked the court to strike out the petition since the second petitioner and it is unknown before this court, relying on the case of Ochieng versus Machani and another. The third respondent submitted that the second petitioner was unknown in this proceeding since his name and address of advocates particulars were not provided for. Contract Rule 8, Sub 1A and F. Having looked at the pleadings filed in court by the petitioners, it is observable that as correctly observed to our deputy governor, but shall declare the candidate nominated by the person who is elected governor, county governor, to have been elected as deputy governor. The position of deputy governor, therefore, assumes elective status when eventually declared so following the win of his nominating candidate for the position of governor. The Elections Act under Section 2 defines an election as a presidential, parliamentary, or county election and includes a by-election, while a county election is defined as one of the elections of a county governor or a member of a county as inclined to agree with the findings of non-inclusion of the deputy governor in an election petition. On my part, therefore, believing I'm right in the interpretation and appreciation of the law, alongside the attendant circumstances, I find that the deputy governor is not a mandatory party in an election petition. Failure to join a deputy governor, in my view, ought not invalidate a petition. In view of the foregoing, the preliminary objection by the first and second respondents and the application by the third respondent must fail. They are hereby dismissed, and the cause shall be in the course.